Good afternoon. We're coming on the air with brand new developments in a rapidly growing public health scare. We have just received word that swine flu, which has killed at least 68 people in Mexico, may have spread across this country to Kansas and New York City. Health officials here in New York have just confirmed 8 students at a Catholic school here have tested positive for what they say is likely swine flu. NBC's Chief Science Editor Robert Bazell joins me now. Bob, how serious is all this and where do we stand?
Right now, Lester, nobody knows exactly how serious it is. The good news is that in the United States, nobody has gotten very sick or died, but clearly we know that this very same strain in Mexico has killed those 68 people. We just don't know how widespread a problem it is or how fast it's going. In addition to the 8 very probable cases here in New York, state officials in Kansas just reported 2 cases, and there are reports of several more cases in Texas, which has reported at least 2 already. So this is something that is spreading across the United States. The good news also is that this virus is treatable by drugs, and if somebody has a fever or other flu-like symptoms, they should get to their doctor as soon as possible.
Robert Bazell, a lot of moving parts to this story. We'll have it all, including a live report from Mexico City on NBC Nightly News. For now, I'm Lester Holt. Dr. Holly Atkinson is the chief medical director of Healthy Nation, a producer of medical videos for the web. Dr. Atkinson, good morning. Thanks so much for joining us.
My pleasure.
You know, a lot of us don't know when we have the regular flu. What should people be looking for? Would the symptoms be similar to what we normally see in the wintertime?
The symptoms of this flu seem to be similar to regular flu, and that is you can have fever, lethargy. You can cough, you can lose your appetite. Some people get really, you know, deep aches and pains. And some people can actually have GI symptoms, so they can have nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea.
Every fall we do the story about getting the flu shot. We know that doesn't protect from all strains. Might it offer some protection to this particular strain?
That's an excellent question. The CDC officials are working on that right now. We don't have the answer.
What is the treatment for swine flu? Do the antivirals that we see with the traditional flu, are they effective?
Another good question. We have 4 antiviral drugs, and the good news is it appears that 2 of the drugs are working with this flu. Now, usually the way you treat flu is you do supportive measures. So all of us have mostly had the flu at some time in our life. You know, you stay home, you drink plenty of fluids, you treat the symptoms. But for those people who are frail or they have chronic diseases and they're ill from something else, you really want to get more aggressive, and so you would consider using some antivirals.
And swine flu does come from pigs, correct?
Yes, and this particular virus is very interesting because it looks like it has genes from 2 different pig viruses, 1 from avian flu and 1 from human flu. And what happens is all these genes mix together and you get a new virus, and that's what we've got.
And in this case, it can be passed from human to human. So what would be the preventative measures one could do if one's going to be out in public?
Very important. I know this doesn't sound sexy, but one of the most important things you can do is wash your hands, wash your hands, wash your hands. The way that flu travels between people is either through droplets in the air that we cough and sneeze, or if someone touches a surface or, for example, drinks out of a cup, cell phones you have to be careful of, passing them back and forth. Objects can get the flu virus on it. So if you touch an object that is contaminated and then touch your nose and your eyes, that's how you infect yourself.
So just good hygiene in this case and being preventative. But we often think of flu as being a winter type thing. It's going to be 80 here in New York City today. It's warm across most of the country.
You know, that's what's so unique about this virus. It's very late in the season for an outbreak like this, and here we are. It's supposed to be 88 degrees in New York tomorrow. So it is very late in the season, which makes it a little novel.
I have to ask this next question. I think I know the answer, but people hear swine flu. Is this anything you could get from eating pork products?
And I'm glad you asked that question. It's very important. No, you don't get this from eating. As I said, you inhale this. It's a respiratory virus, so it has nothing to do with the food we eat.
This is a hard question. Scale of 1 to 10 as a medical professional. How worried are you about this?
We're concerned. We're very concerned. We haven't seen this virus before. We have to take it very seriously. I think one of the things I can say to people to ease their minds is that federal officials, state officials, local officials have been preparing for this kind of thing for years and years now. We've studied other pandemics, and there are a lot of plans in place that should this be a pandemic, if it would become a pandemic, there are a lot of things we can do in the community to stop the spread of the virus.
And I asked you about antivirals. Tamiflu has proven effective with this?
Yes.
All right. Dr. Holly Atkinson, thanks so much for being with us this morning. We appreciate your insight.
We have new reaction from the World Health Organization to the deadly swine flu outbreak in Mexico. That has now crossed into the border in the United States. The head of the WHO saying this morning the situation is evolving quickly and that the flu has the potential to become a pandemic. 8 people in Texas and California have been diagnosed with the illness, but all have recovered. In Mexico, though, dozens have died and more than 1,000 people have taken ill from it. NBC's Michelle Kosinski live in Mexico City for us. So, Michelle, with a good morning to you. Let's get a little bit more about what the WHO just said.
Hi, Alexandra. We just heard from them. They held a teleconference for journalists right before going to a special meeting of its emergency committee. And they said that this does have pandemic potential because this is an animal virus that has spread to humans and now apparently is being transmitted human to human. What will be interesting, though, today, this afternoon, they're in that meeting, which is closed to the public, but they will have information coming out afterward, is whether they raise the pandemic alert level. And that is a big deal. They didn't even do that during the SARS outbreak a couple of years ago. And that would then spark things like potentially travel restrictions. And they said they're really just trying to get a handle right now on the information they have and what, if any, temporary precautions and measures are necessary at this point. Really, here in Mexico City, with about 1,000 people affected by flu, they don't even know how many of those people are affected by this never-before-seen strain, which is being called H1N1. Some people have been tested. Latest numbers show anywhere between a dozen and 20 people have been confirmed affected by that strain. But they're really gathering information at this point, and that is what's so worrisome. And that's why so many people here in the capital city of Mexico are taking those precautions. At the same time, the government just urged calm a few minutes ago, but they are saying that they're going to put mobile health units in certain communities. They're going to be giving out masks, those sorts of precautions that many, many people here are already taking. We've already been hearing schools closed indefinitely. Other public places closed indefinitely. And we're waiting to hear today possibly cancellation of religious ceremonies over the weekend. They may cancel things like masses and even weddings and baptisms, anywhere that, you know, anything that could bring large numbers of people together, Alex.
You know, Michelle, you mentioned SARS, and then you think about the avian flu epidemic, pandemic. I'm curious, what is the last big outbreak to strike on this kind of a scale?
There were smaller outbreaks in the 60s, SARS in 2003, but really the one that people think of and the one that worries people was the one, Spanish flu in 1918 that lasted into 1919. When you look at the numbers on that outbreak, it's unbelievable. Killed anywhere between 20 million and 40 million people worldwide. It affected one-fifth of the planet, Alex, about a quarter of the people in the U.S. I mean, the scale of this was enormous. At the same time, though, when you look at the mortality rate for that outbreak, the death rate was 2.5%. That doesn't sound so great, but, you know, in 2 years' time, the number of deaths was huge. And what's worrisome is that in this case here, which is not really technically being called an outbreak yet, it's affecting primarily young, healthy people between the ages of 25 and 45. That's what they also saw in that 1918 outbreak. So a lot of people are making reference to that. Of course, this is nowhere near that scale. That's the worry, though, and that's why we're talking precautions now.
Well, thankfully, the antibiotics we have now are certainly a lot more effective in dealing with things like this. Okay, Michelle Kosinski, thanks so much.